These North Korean women fled hunger and repression. Now they're learning the art of the manicure. Filing, painting and shaping. It's just one of nearly two dozen courses on offer at the South Korean Reception Center for those who've escaped North Korea and need new skills for their new lives. In another room, defectors are introduced to high-tech devices commonplace in South Korea, less so in the North. They learn about the software that powers these gadgets. The Hanawon Resettlement Center for North Korean refugees is also a medical facility. South Korean doctors try to fix health problems that might have gone untreated for years, from top to toe. Dr. Jun Jin-young is a psychiatrist who's worked at Hanawon. Not surprisingly, he says many defectors suffer with their mental health, not least from being separated from their relatives.
These people have families back in North Korea who they can't see. It's a little like bereavement, but different, because they haven't passed away. They're still there. For the defectors, it's complete torture.
Whatever problems the defectors face, the Hanawon Resettlement Center is just the beginning of their education. The hardest journey starts on the outside. North Koreans who arrive in South Korea aren't just coming to a different place, they're also coming to a different time. In terms of the way people live their lives, South Korea is decades ahead. Imagine suddenly being transported half a century into the future, and you get some idea of the difficulties faced by North Koreans trying to adjust to their new lives here. One of those who's managed to do that is Kim Sung-hui. She started her own business, making a spirit popular in North Korea.
The first night on the outside is a memorable one for all defectors. I hugged my daughter and started to cry, not because I was sad or lonely, but because we've survived.
She's not just survived, she's thrived. Though still at Hanawon, we'll be hoping for a similar success. Michael Bristow, BBC News, Seoul.